The British Broadcasting Corporation proudly presents Flywheel, Shyster and Flywheel.
Officer Flywheel, Shyster, and Flywheel. Miss Dimple speaking. No, Mr. Flywheel isn't in yet. He's in court. Thank you.
Miss Dimple, I need to call the White House.
Oh, Mr. Flywheel, I thought you...
Never mind that. Get President Hoover on the phone. There's a picture of me in the police station, and it doesn't do me justice. It makes me look like my father. In fact, it is my father. Never mind calling the president. Just find out what the reward is.
Mr. Flywheel, I've got some letters for you to sign.
Not now, not now. I've had a big day in court.
What was the case?
Disorderly conduct, but I think I'll get off. Why shouldn't I? She hit me first.
Mr. Flywheel, you hit a woman?
Well, she was my size. Smaller. Besides, if it weren't for my own arrests, I'd never get a case. Any calls?
Yes. Your creditors have been calling all morning. They said they're tired of phoning and something will have to be done.
All right, we'll do something. We'll have the phone taken out.
Okay.
There's a good girl. Your salary is raised $10.
Thank you, Mr. Flywheel.
It's nothing at all. Say, how about lending me that 10 till payday?
But Mr. Flywheel, I haven't been paid in weeks. Besides, you overlooked the fact
I've
that...
overlooked plenty around here. A fine stenographer you are. What do you do with your time? The floors aren't washed, the windows aren't cleaned, and my pants aren't even pressed.
But Mr. Flywheel...
Enough of this small talk. Where's that $10?
I haven't a penny.
Who's asking for a penny? If I wanted a penny, I could go to my baby's bank, if I had a baby. I'm going into my office now. If the phone rings, don't answer it. It may be a wrong number.
Come in.
Hello, my name's Emmanuel Ravelli. Is the boss in?
He's busy. Have you got a card?
Sure, but I take another one. I want to see the boss.
What do you want to see him about?
Well, you see, lady, I want to get a divorce.
Mr. Flywheel's a very busy man. I'll have to fill out a report. Let's see. Any children?
Sure, 6, maybe 7. I know C very good. And then we got the new little baby.
A new little baby? Is it a boy or a girl?
I don't know. He no speak yet.
How long have you been married?
No, I'm not married. My brother, he's married.
Oh, he wants a divorce.
Oh, no, he don't want a divorce. He likes his wife. He's a happy, but I think he's a little bit crazy.
You mean you want him to divorce his wife just because you don't like her?
No, lady, I like her. She's a nice girl, but she's a not a very good cook.
Well, does your brother complain?
No, he's a no complain. He eats out.
Well, why don't you eat out?
Well, you see, lady, I can't afford it. I no got a job.
Why don't you get a job?
All right, never mind the divorce. I'll take the job.
Well, I'll have to talk to Mr. Flywheel. Take a seat. Mr. Flywheel?
Well, did you get the $10?
No. But there's a man out here who wants to talk to you about a job.
Tell him I'll take it. But I won't work for less than $20 a week.
No, he wants a job here.
Oh, he wants a job. Well, I think I can put him to work.
Oh, I don't want to work. I just want a job.
How about references?
Ah, that's all right. You don't need no references. I like your face.
And I like your face. If it is a face. Say, you look exactly like a fellow I used to know by the name of Emmanuel Ravelli. Are you his brother?
I am Emmanuel Ravelli.
You're Emmanuel Ravelli?
I'm Emmanuel Ravelli.
No wonder you look like him. But I still insist there's a resemblance.
He thinks I look alike.
Well, if you do, it's a tough break for both of you.
Hey, we no speak about money.
That suits me fine. If you promise not to say anything about it, I won't mention it either.
All right, but I gotta have more money.
I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you $6 a week and you can bring your own lunches.
Well, I don't know.
I'll go even further than that. I'll give you $6 a week and you can bring lunch for me, too.
That's no good. I can't live on $6 a week.
You can't live on $6 a week? That'll make me very happy. You're hired.
Hey, when do I start?
Well, it's 1 o'clock. If you start now, you can be back here at 3 with the lunch. This is ridiculous, Miss Dimple. I sent Ravelli out over an hour ago for lunch, and he's not back yet. How long can it take to steal cheese from a rat trap? That's probably him now.
I beg your pardon?
Ravelli, you've changed. There's something different about you. No, don't tell me. Let me guess. I know you've grown a beard. Now run along and tie your dog up outside.
Asher no dog, Asher me, boss.
Oh, so that's you, Ravelli. Well, run along and tie your woman up outside.
Hey, Mr. Flywheel, this is a Mrs. Thorndyke. She wants to see you.
Is this a detective agency?
A detective agency? Madam, if there is anything in it for me, this is Scotland Yard.
This man told me he was taking me to a detective bureau.
Ah, you're cuckoo. I did not. You stop me in the hall. You say you want a detective. I say you go see Flywheel. You say, all right, well, here's a Flywheel.
Sir, are you or aren't you a detective? My time is money.
It is? Could you lend me 10 minutes for lunch? How about half an hour for the rent?
For the last time, are you a detective?
Madam, for the first time, I am a detective.
Well, you don't look much like a detective to me.
That's the beauty of it. See, I had you fooled already.
Is this man who brought me in a detective, too?
Sure, I'm a detective. I prove it. Lady, you lose anything today?
Why, I don't think so. Heavens, my handbag has disappeared.
Here it is.
Where did you find it?
Right here, in my pocket.
Isn't he marvelous, madam? He has the nose of a bloodhound. And his other features aren't so bad either. Why, just last week, he followed a woman clear across town on a case.
Sure. Next time I take a taxi, it's a quicker.
Well, I must admit, that does sound very impressive. You're just the men I'm looking for.
You're looking for us? Say, are you a detective?
Oh, no, no, you misunderstand. You see, my daughter is getting married tomorrow.
Oh, your daughter's getting married. I love those old-fashioned girls.
We're having a big wedding reception at Thorndyke Manor.
Say, never mind that. Can I interest you in a ticket for the fireman's ball? It's a $5 ticket, but it's yours for a buck and a half.
Why, this is last year's ticket.
I know it is, but they had a better show last year.
As I was saying, we're having a big wedding reception, and I want you to come out tomorrow afternoon and keep an eye on my wedding present. It's a priceless Rembrandt, and I want to make sure it's not stolen.
How much do you pay us? You know, it's a very hard work not to steal nothing.
Would you take $50? I think that would be adequate.
Adequate? I had to quit the last job I had for taking $50.
I'll be looking for you tomorrow. Goodbye, gentlemen.
Well, boss, I think we got a fine job.
Ravelli, I think I've underrated you. From now on, I'll just think of you as a halfwit.
Ah, sure, fine, boss.
Jumping Jupiter, we're ruined, we're sunk.
What's the matter, boss?
We forgot to get the address from Mrs. Thorndyke.
Don't get excited, boss. I know where her address is.
You do?
Sure, it's in her address book.
Which is in her handbag, genius.
Sure, which is in my pocket.
Mr. Flywheel. How do you do, Mr. Ravelli? Welcome to Thorndyke Manor. I'm so pleased you got here at last.
Well, we had trouble with the car.
Oh, that's too bad. Was it serious?
No, the copy couldn't prove we stole it.
Ah, here's my butler. Meadows, these are the detectives I told you about.
Oh, so you've been discussing us with the servants behind our backs.
Meadows, take these gentlemen's hats and coats and show them whether to guard the Rembrandt.
Very good, milady.
Very good, my eye. Who's going to guard our hats and coats while we guard the painting?
That's all right. I don't want to lose this coat. It don't belong to me. It belonged to a friend of mine.
Oh, you got a friend, have you? Where is he?
He's looking for his coat.
Well, Meadows will take care of you. Oh, dear. I'm always so nervous at weddings. I'm really not myself today.
You're not yourself, huh? Well, whoever you are, you're no bargain.
Meadows? You attend to these gentlemen and show them their duties. I really must fly now.
Well, mind the chandelier when you take off.
In here, gentlemen. This is the painting here.
Never mind about the painting. We want to see where is the kitchen.
Ravelli, what will Meadows think of you? Where were you brought up?
Hey, don't you remember? I was brought up in the elevator. Where are you?
Don't mind him, Meadows. He hasn't been the same since his hat fell out of a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.